What could he be doing?
I'm giving him 10 more minutes, and I gotta go.
I'm finished.
What the hell is it?
I call it the time helmet.
What's it do?
What do you mean, what's it do? It's a time helmet.
Yeah?
It's a time... You put it on your head, I go over here to the control panel, I feed in the date in which you wish to arrive, and then I press this button.
You're crazy.
I am not. It's all right over there in my scientific notes. How about a little recap before we begin? You've chosen to travel to 15th century Spain because of your keen interest in seafaring and world explorers. You've chosen to travel to Nero's Rome because of your penchant for debauchery and loose-fitting clothes. And you've chosen to travel to New York of 1980, where you will attempt to save the life of John Lennon. And I've chosen 18th century England because I like the music. Here we go.
Not what your country can do for you.
Roger, Columbia, last clear, and we copied your monitor, bud.
Hello? Anyone there?
I'm over here.
Oh. I don't understand. We should have all traveled to the same place.
I wonder where we are.
We're right back where we started. Great time helmet.
Look at your hair. You got Spanish explorer hair.
What?
The only thing that traveled back in time was our hair.
Flying seagulls.
Go ahead.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Who's the hair, man? Okay. Have a good night. Go ahead. Okay.
Okay, I'll stay here. I'll be here.
You had a good time at the party?
I had a great time at the party.
Oh, great.
Hey, how was New York?
Oh, New York was great.
Yeah?
Shopper's paradise.
Oh, wow.
You know, you could buy anything there right off the street.
Really?
See these shoes? No tax, no nothing.
Really?
Yep.
Those Doc Martens?
Yeah, well, the guy said they were.
What do you mean, the guy?
The guy sold them to me.
Well, how much were they?
$5.
$5?
$5.
Nice going, Bill.
Higgledy, piggledy, wiggledy, pop, sniggledy, miggledy, diggledy, flop. It's time to watch the show. It's time to watch the show. Hi, boys and girls. and welcome to Mr. Wiggle's Clubhouse. You know, today is a special day, because today is song day. Now, does everyone have their singing voices ready? Great. Tink, could you play us a song? This old man, he played one. He played knick-knack on my thumb with a knick-knack, paddywhack, give a dog a bone. This old man came rolling home. This old man, he played two. He touched me! What's that, Tink? Yes, I am happy. I'm extra happy today because I'm in remission. Good idea, Tink. Let's check the mailbag. Pumpkin spider. Now here's a letter, and let's see what it says. Today's letter is from Jason in Topeka, and he writes, Dear Mr. Wiggles, where does meat come from? Your friend Jason. Well, what a great question. Now, you're lucky today, Jason, because I have my good friend, Mr. D'Agostino, coming over, and he's going to tell us all about where meat comes from. Hello, Mr. D'Agostino.
Hi.
Now, you're going to tell us all about where meat comes from?
Yeah, sure. I brought a clip. Is that okay?
That's super. Tink, could you roll the clip?
Okay, well, the first thing is the product comes down this chute, and we put a piston through its brain. The carcass is hung upside down and moves along the shop floor for processing. Its legs are sheared, and then the torso is gutted and sprayed with steam to disinfect the intestinal cavity.
Now, being clean is very important, isn't it?
Yeah, okay. Anyway, once the head's been removed, we begin cutting the beef up into sides and shanks for storage. The last phase is cutting it for sale. You got your round steak, your T-bone, your butt steak, your flank steak, that sort of thing.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. D'Agostino. We learned something new today, and I hope that answers your question, Jason. What's that, Tink? Is it that time already? Well, okay, boys and girls, let's stick out our thumbs and hitch a ride to Fingertown.
Here we come then, man.
Well, that's all the time we have for today. I'd like to thank Mr. D'Agostino and the good people of Fingertown, and especially you, for coming to Mr. Wiggles' Clubhouse. So... Higgledy, piggledy, wiggledy, pop, smiggledy, miggledy, diggledy, flop. It's time to say goodbye. It's time to say goodbye. Goodbye, everybody!
Mr. D'Agostino appears courtesy of CMA Local 137.
This is gonna be amazing.
Yeah, you know, a solar eclipse only happens once every few years.
Is that right?
Yep.
I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, what are those?
Eclipsers. They're special eclipse-watching glasses.
Eclipsers?
Yeah.
Are you sure they're safe?
Yeah, well, the guy who sold them to me said they were safe.
Well, where'd you get them?
New York. Right off the street.
Oh, yeah? How much?
$5.
$5?
$5.
bucks.
Wow.
Oh, look, it's starting.
Oh.
Beautiful. Oh. Oh. Oh.
Oh. Phil.
Who's there? Who's there?
It's here.
I'll open it up.
Yeah, open it up. Duh. Oh, yeah, this is great. Excellent.
Okay, shut up. I don't know how to turn it off. It bit you, didn't it?
No.
Did he bite you?
No.
Did he bite you?
Yeah.
Hold him down.
What are you going to do?
Just hold it down. Just. Did you bite him? Did you bite him? Did you bite him? Ah! $15 for that. You pay good money for something, you should get something you can use. You know, a conversation piece, hold down the pages of a nice coffee table book. But this is useless. It's a stupid screaming machine.
No! Well, I say we try it again.
Oh, okay, sure. Shove something in its mouth.
Throw me that apple.
Now it's humming.
Well, that's not so bad. I mean, I could get used to humming.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, I could get used to humming, too. I don't mind humming so much. I'm already used to it.
Hey, what are you doing? Just solve the problem. What the hell, it's my problem to solve.
Yeah, well, then solve it.
All right.
Look, there's a toll-free number on the box. I'm going to call them and see if they can help.
Oh, hey, I got an idea.
What?
We'll boil it.
What good's a boiled head?
It'll be fun.
The bow! Your love! Got the bow! The bow! No answer. Look, I say we try and reason with it.
Reason with it?
It's 90% brain.
Be my guest. Go on.
Okay, look. I'm gonna take the apple out of your mouth, and I don't want to hear any screaming, and I don't want to hear any humming, okay? Okay.
Oh, Lenny, now it's crying.
Hey, well, at least he's not humming anymore, right? Look, shut up, okay? Look, shut up. Because if you don't shut up, we're going to have to shove something in your mouth again.
And this time, it ain't going to be no apple.
Sorry, you're scaring him. Have you ever think baby's just hungry or something?
Hungry? Give me a break.
Pass me a popcorn.
Oh, yeah.
That's great. Oh, make him go faster. That's great. Faster.
That's really good. Hey, what's he doing now?
Hey, what's the matter? Did a colonel go down the wrong pipe?
What pipe? It's a stinking severed head.
Walter, do something.
What do you want me to do?
I don't know. Heimlich him or something.
Heimlich him where? How? What are you talking about?
Walter is dying. He's dying. He's dead. What a chip! Oh, man! I'm out 15 bucks and I got a dead head! That's just great! My head is dead, Walter! My head is dead, Walter! I got a dead head, Walter!
Relax.
Oh, why don't you go relax, Mr. Relaxation, huh? You want me to relax like that? Because that's not relaxed, Walter! That's dead, Walter!
Well, now what do we do?
Well, now we can boil the bastard!
All right!
Good part is, I get 13 for 1 cent. Bad part is, I don't know what I'm gonna do with all those monkeys.
Yeah.
Well, Christmas is coming up.
Yeah, you could dump a few that way.
I never thought of it like that.
Hi.
Hi. I'll have a coffee, please.
Okay.
Decaf, thanks.
When did you start drinking decaf?
Ever since the operation.
Operation? What operation?
I had an artificial heart put in when I was in New York.
Really?
Mm-hmm. And the guy said I'm not supposed to have any stimulants, you know, like caffeine.
The guy? Don't you mean the doctor?
I guess he was a doctor.
Well, an operation like that must cost a lot of money.
Well, not really.
How much?
$5.
$5?
$5.
Wow. Thanks. So anyway...
I think you have my decaf.
Take care of your man. And now I'm asking you to do me this favor. And I don't expect you to understand. Pamper me, put me in diapers. 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 Let's make it romantic, I'd like to remember. Blow out the candles and drink all the wine. But what's the big deal? It's really so simple. You do your duty and watch me do mine. Yeah, yeah. Pamper me, put me in diapers. Pamper me, no really put me in diapers. Pamper me, come on, put me in diapers. Pamper me, please, put me in diapers. Lay a blanket on the floor. Slap some powder on my thighs. Stick a soother in my mouth. Just don't tell the other guy. Me, no really put me in diapers, pamper me, come on, put me in diapers, pamper. diapers, pamper me. I beg you, put me in diapers, pamper me. Come on, put me in diapers, pamper me. I beg you, put me in diapers, pamper me. Please put me in diapers.